How's it going, hominids? I'm Alex, and I'm one of the science kids. I have a challenge for you. Imagine you're a basketball player. There are just 3 seconds left in the game. You're losing by 1 point. If you make the shot, you win the championship. Your teammate across the court just passed you, and now it's all up to you. You reach for the ball and are ready to shoot. What happens next? Tune in next time on The Science. Just kidding, I wouldn't do that to you. I'll tell you in a bit what happens. But first, imagine what's going on in your brain. All of this happens in just a few seconds. Imagine how complicated that is for your brain to process. It's like trying to code Jarvis from Avengers on your flip phone. Thankfully, our brain has different lobes responsible for different things. And that's the topic of today's video. We're gonna be talking about brain lobes and what they do. Number one, frontal lobe, or prefrontal cortex if you wanna sound fancy. This is the part of the brain that makes you, you. The frontal lobe has 3 main functions: planning and reasoning, emotional control, and memory. You can kind of call your frontal lobe your personality center because that's what it is. It makes your personality, and it allows you to make decisions based on your personality. Next, parietal lobe. Parietal lobe, or as I like to call it, the center of senses, is the center of senses. The parietal lobe processes the feeling of touch, visuospatial reasoning, and even our reflexes. Next, the temporal lobe. The temporal lobe controls memory. Hold on, Alex, you said the frontal lobe was for memory, not the temporal lobe. How could you lie to me like this? First of all, calm down. Second of all, more than one lobe can control one thing. The temporal lobe also controls audio input. Temporal lobe also allows us to recognize language. So everything I'm saying right now, your temporal lobe allows you to understand it. Next, occipital lobe. Occipital lobe controls your vision. That's pretty much it. Next, cerebellum. Cerebellum isn't considered a lobe by the scientists, but we'll just consider it a lobe for now. The cerebellum is largely responsible for movement and balance, so you being able to move your eyes and watch me is because of your cerebellum. Try balancing on one foot without a cerebellum. Trust me, it's not fun at all. Lastly, the brainstem. Brainstem is basically basic. That's what it is, the most basic form of human nature. It controls the impulses that you don't even think about, like breathing, having a heartbeat, wanting to eat food, wanting to drink water, you know, that kind of stuff. Hey, oxygen, that's awesome. Hey, tiger, run away. So in conclusion, brainstem is very important because it controls our basic impulses. Okay, let's put this all back together, but with a basketball example. 3 seconds left in the game and you're 1 point behind. The parietal lobe allows you to understand numbers. The frontal lobe takes that information and pumps adrenaline into your body, making you nervous. When your teammate shouts your name, your temporal lobe processes auditory information and language to understand that. You can see the basketball coming at you thanks to your occipital lobe, and your frontal lobe tells you what that is. The temporal lobe tells you that you've touched something, and the parietal lobe and cerebellum reflexively allow you to shoot the ball. The occipital lobe tells you the location of the ball and the location of the rim. Finally, the temporal lobe hears the audio information of everyone on your team, on the opponent's team, and in the audience. In conclusion,
epic fail!
Oh my god! Well, we hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for our next few videos. Subscribe to our channel over here and check out some of our other videos over here. Links to the social media pages are in the description. And as always, science is everywhere and in everything. Bye!